Hello, been a while, but still listening to music, getting new music occasionally as well. So I thought I'd share some of the stuff I've been up to listening to lately. So here's a couple of 7 inches that I've been listening to lately. Now, Laurel was a singer from the, well, he became famous as a solo singer in the 70s and 80s. Laurel Simon, but he was originally part of the group The Lost Generation, proper Chicago harmony group. But as a solo artist, I think his most famous song is probably Mellow Mellow Right On, long sort of 10-minute groovy opus. And what I've been listening to lately is, I guess it's a follow-up, maybe this is from 1981, Love Massage. Basically, the same thing, a big farty bass line which goes with you through the motions. And this is a nice little 7-inch. There is a 12-inch, which is a bit longer and more smooching in the background. But yeah, this is a great, really nice little funky number. And here's a nice one by DJ Rogers. Now, he's an artist who has lots of albums which are all very, generally very affordable, not too difficult to get. But I find that they tend to be a bit more miss than hit for me. But this is a lovely little 7-inch. Listen to the Message by DJ Rogers, which has got a nice level of funkiness, which I really appreciate. And just one more to show because I quite like this. It's a bit of a silly song, but it's really fun, by an artist called Ben Sidran, who's a sort of jazz pianist, I think. It's a nice little 7-inch song for a sucker like you. I like that one. It's quite a sort of groovy little pop number, but yeah, really quite amusing lyrics, I think. Anyway, on to the albums, which are probably a bit more interesting. Since I last made a video, which seems like ages now, Larry Harlow sadly passed away, the great pianist, famous for his work with Fania Records and the Latin sound of New York in the 1970s. And he's a fascinating character. There's lots of interviews you can find with him on YouTube, and he likes to tell a story. He can go on, but everything he says is quite interesting, and his life is fascinating, really. He became interested in Latin music, grew up in a musical family, but he travelled around Cuba just before the revolution, and which is where he really caught the bug with Latin music and saw all of the great musicians that were around there. And he made recordings, did all sorts of things. He was a real student of the music, if you like. And then slowly managed to get into the scene in New York himself, taking it very seriously, organizing some pretty serious bands himself, using his classical music education in his piano playing, as a lot of great Latin pianists do. You can hear that classical influence, a lot of them. And then he went on, made some great records with his bands, with the singer he's most associated with, Ismael Miranda. There's a compilation of the two of them together with some of his best songs here. Arsenio, Abraham Passon, really famous one, Señor Sereno. Yeah. Really, really nice. I don't actually have many or any albums by him. They're all quite hard to get and quite expensive. So, but that's a nice little comp. he took it. Yeah, he also did productions, and was even went as much far as being like a priest in the Santeria sort of Cuban, Afro-Cuban religion. So he took it very seriously and very highly respected, obviously. And a great, great character. So sad that he passed away. So yeah, I think I've shown that before. That's a Larry Harlow production. Quite cool little logo to show the Larry Harlow Productions. That's his brother Andy. And this is a really nice one, which for connoisseurs of salsa is considered one of the finest records ever. Again, this is from Larry Harlow Productions. This is Beethoven's Fifth by Marcolino de Monde and Frankie Dante, with guest star Chivilico. the bottom there. Amusing cover, this. They went through a stage of Fania Records, or this is actually on Kotike Records, but having these, Johnny Pacheco's got one where they're all dressed up as sort of French revolutionary fops or something like that, would you say? Anyway, Marcolino de Monde is a pianist, and he's one of those full-blooded, like a very strong red wine is the sound that you get from his piano, which is wonderful. Again, a bit like Larry Harlow, not Latin in his origins. He was an African-American pianist, very highly regarded. He didn't make many records because sadly his career fizzled out very quickly due to drugs. And there's not that much known about him. There's not many pictures or anything apart from that belter. But he did this, and he did another record with Angel Canales, which is really good as well. And he has that lovely full-bodied piano playing style. And yeah, the heavy salsa people absolutely love this record. The title track, El Quinto de Beethoven, obviously takes a Latin stab at Beethoven's Fifth, which sounds very cheesy, but they pull it off quite majestically. And there's other great stuff on this album, so really, really, really nice one, Matt. Larry Harlow is sort of not such a big presence on this album, but it was produced by him, so I thought I'd show that. Here was a nice one that I've been listening to. Most famous for the MGs, here's Booker T on his own, Evergreen, this album it's called, a bit of reflection there. It's him solo. When's this from? 1974. And it's sort of taking almost a slightly singer-songwriter approach to his music. There's some tracks here which are very much that Booker T sound, which we recognise from the great Stax records. But there's a sort of real interesting hodgepodge of other stuff, some country influence, slight sort of Caribbean influence perhaps, but yes, interesting stuff. I think sometimes people forget that he was a pretty serious musician, and he did lots of great stuff after Stax, and this is an interesting record with stuff on it definitely worth checking out and investigating. Here's a nice one. This is a new acquisition. I was in a place I normally go, and this was recommended to me, Mary Watkins, Something Moving. Now, interesting, this on Olivia Records, which is quite famous because it was a label in California, Oakland, California, formed entirely by women, and it had a very much pro-feminist agenda. Perhaps the most famous artist that I knew before I got this was Linda Tillery, who has quite a famous, really nice, funky tune as well. But this is really great as well, Mary Watkins. It's almost like there's a lot of similarity perhaps to a Patrice Rushen album, but there's really good stuff on it. According to the People, I think is the one a lot of people go to. But yeah, side one particularly really, really got some nice, interesting stuff. So yeah, Olivia Records is an interesting phenomenon worth finding out about. But yeah, great stuff on there. And finally, a new record. Not just new because I bought it new, but it's actually recent release. And I only bought it because the lady who made it actually works in a shop, which when I'm feeling rich, I go and visit Yo-Yo Records in East London, which is very famous for being incredibly expensive, but having really rare records, which everybody wants. But anyway, the lady is called Nala Sinefro, and this is on Warp Records. And she is a sort of, well, she plays the harp, but I think she plays a lot of sort of synthesizers and keyboards as well on this. It's a very spaced out thing. The album is called Space 1.8. And it is really, I mean, it's not almost like a record that I don't actually listen to as much as you have as a sort of mood that goes on, because it's all very sort of soft tones, dreamy, things going on in the background. You've got a lot of jazz musicians. Nubia Garcia seems to ring a bell, I would say. Yeah, I can't pretend I know the current crop of UK jazz musicians, but I think a lot of them are on this. Really, really lovely record. I wanted to get something different. Sometimes I always listen to the same thing, so it was really nice to get something unlike most of the records I have, which does something quite different. And I'm really pleased I got this, because I think it's quite difficult, suddenly become quite difficult to get, and they're not going to repress it for a while, apparently. The way things are, I think it's difficult to do it. So yeah, lovely record. If you've got that one, or you do see it by any chance, give it a listen, because it definitely puts you in a nice mellow place, which is where I quite often like to be. So yeah, that's what I've been listening to mainly. A few new things as well. Hope everybody's well. I do still watch videos, and I can see there's lots of debate about what it means to collect records. And people talking about whether you should make videos about what you've just bought or what you've been listening to. It sounds a bit exhausting, frankly, but I do like to share this and get a bit of feedback occasionally, which is always nice to know there's other people out there. But anyway, I might put one or two samples on, see how we feel. Until next time, take it easy.
Sucker like you.